Every day the headlines are showing us how difficult it is with the coronavirus for people in prison. This is an article that was published today in the New York Times. It was just published 6 hours ago, and today, just for the record, is April the 9th, Thursday. And this tells a story about Cook County Jail, where more than 350 people are currently exposed to or infected with the coronavirus. This is really a troubling situation for any family member who has a loved one in prison. And I'm just going to scroll through the article here so that you can get a look at it and get a better understanding about what's going on in our nation's prison and how it influences people in society. This started with only two people, as I recall reading, two inmates at the sprawling Cook County Jail. I don't like to say inmates, just call it people. Two people that are confined in the Cook County Jail were placed in isolation after testing positive for the coronavirus. But in 2 weeks, the virus exploded with more than 350 people being now contaminated with this virus or infected with this virus. I don't know what the right word is, but I do know that it's awful. There are 238 people now and 115 staff members. That's a massive amount of people inside of the institution, but it says that they don't even really know how many there are because there's 4,500 people there. So it's really important, I think, for family members of loved ones who have people in prison to understand what steps they can be taking to advocate. And so I'm going to keep putting this type of information out there with hopes that people will do what they need to do to advocate on behalf of their loved ones. It says here that in the Federal Bureau of Prisons, there are 337 positive cases right now and 8 deaths. But that's not testing everyone. I mean, there's 175,000 plus people in the Federal Bureau of Prisons, and they locking them into a cell doesn't protect them against the coronavirus. This young fella, Tom Balsinger, 67, at Latuna in Texas, he has coronary heart disease, and he's just, you know, dealing with the anxiety that if he gets this, he knows what it could mean for him because they're not going to have the care. And that's the reason that people who have loved ones in prison need to be thinking about what can they do to advocate on behalf of their loved ones to get them home. And it's really just about advocacy. It's about bringing attention to why the prisons are unsafe for people, why the person is going to be safer at home, how he, in prisons, he is not allowed to wash his hands as frequently because there's just restrictions of movement. He can't get to the facilities if they're on lockdown. He can't get access to the type of hand sanitizer and cleaning that or cleaning solvents to even clean his cell. And so, you know, there's just so much data showing that the virus can spread through the air, that it transmits more than 6 feet. Social distancing is impossible in there. And yet there's the people are still locked inside. So if I were in there, I would definitely be building a positive case, describing the situation to prison authorities and then to judicial authorities, to a judge. And there are mechanisms to do that, that a person can do on his own. And if the person doesn't know how, they can hire somebody. They don't necessarily have to hire a lawyer. They just need to hire somebody who understands the prison system and understands what he or she can be doing to bring attention and awareness to the case and to show that it's a problem of proportions that we've never seen before. It doesn't only make the prisoners safe, the person in prison unsafe, but it also makes staff members, other people in prison, and then the community at large, because the more that it spreads, the dangerous it is for everybody. So I'm hopeful that sharing this information in this one central location is helpful.